Yes, good morning students. My name is Charan Singh. My education qualification is MSc Chemistry. I would like welcome to all to our college Sri Sai Vidya Bharati, and our college is excellent college in the Twin Cities. We have excellent studies along extracurricular activities. We also conduct extra study hour at the time of quarterly and half yearly examination. We also conduct freshers party and farewell party in our colleges. So we teach chemistry subject. So in our college I teach chemistry subject. In our college MPC, BIPC, CEC and MPC groups are there. Here we teach both MPC and BIPC groups. I teach both MPC and BIPC groups. Here MPC stands for Maths, Physics, Chemistry, and BIPC stands for Biology. These biology, which are divided into parts, botany and zoology, physics and chemistry. So we teach both MPC and BIPC. So here chemistry is the common for both MPC and BIPC. Chemistry subject is very important subject for both the groups. This subject is useful for MPC, MCET, IIT. For BIPC, it is useful MCET and NEET. MCET and NEET. So in chemistry there are 13 chapters. These 13 chapters are atomic structure, classifications of element based on properties, chemical bonding, states of matter, stoichiometry, thermodynamics, third group, fourth group, S block, hydrogen and its compound, chemical equilibrium and acid and base, organic chemistry and environmental chemistry. So basically in this among these 13 chapter, if you remember this atomic structure, 50% topics are there in the 10th class, in our previous class. Other 50% are we discuss in our college, in our first year. So maximum the atomic structure, what are the topics? Orbital, quantum numbers, Bohr's theory of the atom, hydrogen spectrum lines, rules of electronic configuration, that is off-bow rule, Hund's rule, Pauli exclusive principle. These 5 topics are there in the 10th class. So if you remember, as it is in the intermediate first year also the topic is there. So in the 50% topics in the atomic structure in 10th class, other 50% of the discussion first year, that is new topic. So that's where chemistry subject is very easy. If you remember atomic structure and periodic table, you can easily pass out. So this is among this one. For in our intermediate IP paper, that means intermediate board examination paper, that chemistry contain 16 marks paper. Chemistry contain 16 marks paper. So these which are divided into three parts, that is section A, this is section B, and third one is section C. Section B, section C. In section A, answer all the following questions. Answer all the following questions. That means in the first section there is no choice. In the first section there is no choice. That means you have to write compulsory all questions, and all questions you should write chronological order. That means 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So each question contain 2 marks. That's why 10 into 2 equal 20 marks. In the section B, answer any 6 of the following questions. Answer any 6 of the following questions. That 6 of the following question means 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Among these 8 questions, you have to write any 6. Each question carrying 4 marks. That's why 24 marks. Now, section C. Answer any 2 of the following questions. So that is 19, 20, 21. So each question contain 8 marks, 2 into 8 equal to 16. That's why total marks is 60 marks paper. Now in this one, here 19, 20, 21. This 19th question is atomic structure question. 20th question is chemical bonding. 19th question is atomic structure, 20th question is chemical bonding, and 21st question is this chemical bonding or organic chemistry. See, 19th question atomic structure, 20th question classification of elements based on properties, 21st question either chemical bonding or organic chemistry. So, if you remember what are the your 10th class topic is there, if you read that, here also same topic. So, that's where chemistry is very easy. So, in the 19th, so what are the atomic structure topics there? Orbitals, quantum numbers, hydrogen spectrum lines, Bohr's theory of the atom, and some rules of electronic configuration of Hund's rule, Pauli exclusive principle, of Bohr principle. These topics are in the 10th class. Here also same topic. So maximum 50% topics are in the 10th class, 50% topics are in the intermediate first year. That's why 19th question is atomic structure. And 20th is classification based on periodic property. 21, either chemical bonding or organic chemistry. So this is our IP question paper pattern. Among these 60 paper, the first marks is 21 by 60. First mark is 21 by 60. So this is IP paper. So this is IP question paper pattern. So actually, chemistry paper is chemistry subject is very easy. So we teach MCET level, MCET, NEET, IIT level. Yes, so chemistry is 60 marks paper. Now for example, if you discuss this atomic structure, this topic is 50% topic is there in the 10th class. So for example, if orbital, so what is the definition of orbital? the space around the nucleus where the probability of finding electron is maximum are called orbital. These orbitals are four types, that is S orbital, P orbital, D orbital, F orbital. Now let us S orbital. S orbital means, so orbital means the space around the nucleus, the space around the nucleus where the probability of finding electron is maximum are called orbital. These orbitals are four types, S orbital, P orbital, D orbital, F orbital. S orbital means, in S orbital, L equal to 0, N equal to 1, S orbital shape is spherical shape. S orbital shape is spherical shape. That spherical means, this is spherical. In this, there is no nodal plane for 1s, 1s, 2s, 3s respectively. That means, in S orbital, it has in S orbital, L equal to 0, L equal to 0, L equal to 1. S orbital shape is spherical shape. Spherical means like this one. In S orbital, there is no nodal plane for 1s, 2s, 3s respectively. Now see, for example, P orbital. In this P orbital, it is also something like this. Here L equal to 0, here L equal to 1, here L equal to 1, here L equal to 2. Its shape is spherical, its shape is dumbbell. It has no nodal plane. Dumbbell means this is dumbbell. So this is half, one lobe. This is another half, another lobe. That means how many lobes? This one lobe, this one lobe. It is two lobes. Two lobes equal to one nodal plane. Two lobes equal to one nodal plane. So P orbital is denoted by, it contains three orbitals. So this is PX, this is PY, this is PZ. PX, it is dumbbell, it is also dumbbell, it is also dumbbell. So this is P orbital. In P orbital, L equal to 1, L equal to 2, P orbital shape is dumbbell shape, dumbbell means this one. It has two lobes. It has two lobes. Lobes mean this half one, this half one. That's why it is two lobes. Two lobes, nothing but one nodal plane. The P orbital is designated as PX, PY, PZ. At the same time, next D orbital. In this D orbital, see, here L equal to 0, L equal to 1, L equal to 2. Here, L equal to 2, L equal to 2, N equal to L2, here L equal to 3. That means increasing order. So what happened? L equal to 0, L equal to 1, L equal to 2. N equal to 1, 2, 3. Spherical dumbbell, this one double dumbbell. So this one double dumbbell. Double dumbbell. This double dumbbell means it is designated as like this. This is dumbbell. This is double dumbbell. So here, this is one, half, one. One lobe, second lobe, third lobe, fourth lobe. It contains four lobes. Nodal plane. One, two. It contains two nodal plane. Orbital is designated as, it contains five orbital. It contains 5 orbital means the orbital is designated as, this is DXY, this is DYZ, this is DZX, this is DX square minus Y square, this is D, Z. In these five are the first two three ardas are called one set, and the two ardas are called another set. That means the first two three ardas are called T2G set. The first two out of three ardas are called T2G set. Other two ardas are called EG set. Other two ardas are called EG set. So this is D arda. Now F arda. What is the F arda? Now let us F arda. F arda here L equal to 3. L equal to 3. N equal to 4. N equal to 4. It is spherical dumbbell, double dumbbell, four whole dumbbell. Four whole dumbbell. That four whole dumbbell means, so this is dumbbell. This is double dumbbell. This is triple dumbbell. This is four whole dumbbell. These four whole dumbbells is nothing but complex. These four whole dumbbells is nothing but complex. It has how many lobes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 lobes. 8 lobes. Nodal plane. 1, 2, 3. 3 nodal plane. 3 nodal plane. The order, this is F arda. So now what is arda? This topic is already there in the class. So this topic already there in the class. So what is arda? First arda means that it contains 8 marks. It is 8 marks with each other. So arda means the space around the nucleus where the probability of finding electron is maximum. Where maximum is there, na? That maximum is 90%. It's called ardal. Ardal is four types: S ardal, P ardal, D ardal, F ardal. S ardal. In S ardal, n equal to 0, n equal to 1. It is spherical in shape. Structure is this one. It has no nodal plane. It has no nodal plane. No nodal plane. For 1s, 2s, 3s respectfully. P arda. L equal to 1, L equal to 2. It is double in shape. Double like this one. It has two lobes. 1, 2. And one nodal plane. Arda is visited as Px, Py, Pz. D arda. In the D arda, L equal to 2, L equal to 3. It is double dumbbell shape. This one, this is dumbbell, this is double dumbbell. It has four lobes, 1, 2, 3, 4, four lobes and two nodal plane, 1, 2. Arda is designated as dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus x square and dz square. These five ardas are split into two sets. That is, the first three ardas are TTG set of arda. Other two ardas are EG set of ardas. Next, F arda. In F arda, L equal to 3, L equal to 4. It is four whole dumbbell in shape. Four whole dumbbell is nothing but complex structure. It has eight lobes, three nodal planes. So this is arda. Next, quantum numbers. So what is the quantum numbers? These quantum numbers also there in the class, in our 10th class. Next, quantum numbers. Quantum numbers. These quantum numbers are basically four types. That is, these are four types. They are principal quantum number, Asymptotic quantum number, magnetic quantum number, and then spin quantum number. Principal quantum number, Asymptotic quantum number, magnetic quantum number, and then spin quantum number. So what is principal quantum number? Now let us, these are four types. The first one, principal quantum number. Principal quantum number. Second one, Asymptotic quantum number. Asymptotic the quantum number. Third one, magnetic quantum number. Magnetic quantum number. Fourth one, spin quantum number. Spin quantum number. So this topic is also there in our 10th class. So what is, now let us review quantum number. Now principal quantum number. Principal quantum number. This principal quantum number, it is denoted by symbol n. It is denoted by symbol n. It was introduced by Niels Bohr. It was introduced by Niels Bohr. Niels Bohr. In the principal quantum number, number of orbital in orbit equal to n square. Number of orbital in orbit equal to n square. In the principal quantum number, number of electron in orbit equal to 2n square. Number of electron in orbit equal to 2n square. This principal quantum number, number of orbital in fixed orbit, that is En, fixed orbit equal to minus 13.6 by n square into e. So this is principal quantum number. So this principal quantum number indicate size and energy of the electrons. Principal quantum number indicates size and energy of electron. Energy of electron. So this is principal quantum number. So what is the principal quantum number? It is denoted by n. It was introduced by Niels Bohr, and in the principal quantum number, number of orbital in orbit equal to n square, number of electron in orbit equal to 2n square. In the principal quantum number, number of orbital in fixed orbit equal to minus 13.6 by n square into e. So this principal quantum number indicates size and energy of the electron. Next, Azimuthal quantum number. What is the definition of Azimuthal quantum number? Now second one is Azimuthal quantum number. So this Azimuthal quantum number, it is denoted by symbol L. It is denoted by symbol L. Azimuthal quantum number, it was introduced by Sommerfeld. It was introduced by Sommerfeld, and it is denoted by symbol L. In this Azimuthal quantum number, the maximum L and L equal to N minus 1. L equal to N minus 1. In this Azimuthal quantum number, the number of orbital in fixed orbit, that means 2N plus 1. The number of orbital in subset equal to 2L plus 1. In this L equal to 0, that is S orbital. So simply 2 into 0 plus 1 equal to 1. 1 means which orbital? S orbital. So S orbital shape is what is? Spherical. S orbital shape is spherical. If in that formula, 2 into L plus 1, if L equal to 1, L equal to 1. So what is? 2 into 1 plus 1 equal to 3. 3 means which orbital? P orbital. So this is P orbital. P orbital shape is what is? Dumbbell shape. P orbital shape is dumbbell shape. Now the same thing, 2 into L plus 1 equal to, if L equal to what about 2? L equal to 2 into 2 plus 1 equal to 5. 5 which are the D orbital. D orbital shape is what is? 4 bull dumbbell. 4 bull dumbbell. At the same time, L equal to 3. 2 into 3 plus 1 equal to what happened? 7. 7 means which are the F orbital. F orbital shape is? Sorry, this is double dumbbell. Double dumbbell. This is 4 bull dumbbell. It's nothing but complex. is nothing but complex. That means azimuthal quantum numbers are explain the shape of orbitals. Azimuthal quantum numbers are explain the shape of orbital. This is azimuthal quantum number. So what is principal quantum number? It is denoted by n. It was introduced by Niels Bohr. The number of orbital in orbit equal to n square. The number of electron in orbit equal to 2n square. In the principal quantum number, number of orbital in fixed orbit equal to minus 13.65 n square eV. It indicates size and energy of the electrons. So this is principal quantum number. Next, azimuthal quantum number. It is denoted by symbol L. It was introduced by Sommerfeld. The number of orbital in subset equal to 2L plus 1. In that formula, L equal to 0. That is SRL set is spherical. If L equal to 1, PRL, that set is dumbbell. If L equal to 2, DRL, that set is double dumbbell. If L equal to 3, FRL, that set is 4 full dumbbell or complex. That means, azimuthal quantum numbers are explained the shape of orbital. Azimuthal quantum numbers are explain the shape of orbital. Next, third one is magnetic quantum number. This magnetic quantum number, it was introduced by Landé. And it is denoted by symbol m, where m equal to minus L2 plus L over 0, minus L2 plus L over 0. That means the maximum m value for m equal to 2L plus 1. M equal to 2L plus 1. That means in this again, 2, if L equal to 1, if L equal to 1, what happened? 2 into 1 plus 1 equal to 3. 3 means PR. So PR means this is 0, this is minus 1, this is plus 1. Minus L to plus L via 0. Minus 1 to plus 1 via 0. See, for example, If L equal to 2, 2 into 2 plus 1 equal to 5. 5 means which are the DR. 5 means DR. So what happened? This is 0. This is minus 1. This is minus 2. Plus 1. Plus 2. Minus L2 plus L via 0. The same time. If L equal to 3, 2 into 3 plus 1 equal to 7. 7 means which are the F or the 7 means F or the. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. So that means what happened here? Minus L2, plus L, via 0. That means this magnetic quantum number indicates the orientation of orbital in space. This magnetic quantum number indicates the orientation of orbital in space. Orbital in space. So this is what is magnetic quantum number. The next last one is spin quantum number. Spin, that is fourth one. Spin quantum number. What is the spin quantum number? The spin quantum number means, for example, in each orbital, maximum, each one orbital contain 2 electrons. One orbital contain 2 electrons. So these 2 electrons is designated as plus of and minus of. Plus of and minus of. Plus of is denoted by upward. Minus of is denoted by downward. Plus of is denoted by upward. Minus of is denoted by downward. Plus of rotating clockwise, plus of rotating clockwise, minus of rotating anti-clockwise, minus of rotating anti-clockwise. That means spin quantum numbers indicate the spin of the electrons. Spin quantum number indicate the spin of the electrons. So this spin quantum number, it was introduced by Uhlenbeck and Goldsmith. Uhlenbeck and Goldsmith, and it is denoted by symbol S. And it is denoted by symbol S. This is for them. So these topics also there in our third class. So what is quantum number? These are four types: principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, maverick quantum number, spin quantum number. These principles say we touch just to what is different between all. So principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, maverick quantum number, spin quantum number. It was introduced by Niels Bohr. That was introduced by Sommerfeld. It is Lambe, it is Uhlenbeck and Goldsmith. It is denoted by N, L, M, S. So it indicates the size and energy of the electron. Azimuthal quantum number indicates the shape of the orbital. Maverick quantum number indicates the orientation of orbital in space. Spin quantum number indicates the spin of the electrons. So this is quantum number. So these orbitals and quantum number, these two topics and other topics also there in our 10th class. So that's why chemistry subject is very easy. And other topics also there, that is Hydrogen spectrum lines and Bohr's theory of the atom and some rules of electronic configuration, that is half Bohr principle, Pauli exclusive principle, Hund's rule. So maximum 50% topics are there in the 10th class. Other 50% topic we discuss in that other 50% topic are in intermediate first year. So basically this chemistry is very easy. Very easy. And okay, thank you.